Hi, I'm Vanessa Morano from Switched at Birth, and you're watching richgirlnetwork.tv. It's just exciting in general to be on a show that you like, because, you know, so often you don't get those opportunities to be on something that, A, really is making a difference out there, and is a well-done show, and really you like everybody that you work with. So that's really exciting, too. But yeah, I've never done a show really, like, I've done shows that resonated with fans quite a bit, but I've never done a show that has resonated with an entire community the way that this show has with the deaf community. And it's great, because it's super awesome to have a community that is so supportive of you, and is really appreciative of you. And we're appreciative of them in return. My character, out of all the characters on the show, really has grown the most in a positive way. She started out very, very difficult, teenage-y, angsty, and she's come a long way. Like, even when she started going to the deaf school, and she was an outcast there, nobody wanted her there. Old Bay would have just fall into pieces, but this Bay, after everything that she's been through, really was like, nope, I'm here, and I am staying, and I am going to make the best of my situation. So just even in that, she's grown. And so I hope she continues on that path. Now, that being said, a lot of things get thrown at her, as they do in a television show. And so it's really, really for Bay, it is that sort of, just in general, the way that you grow from being a teenager into an adult. And it's just taking responsibility for yourself and your actions, and learning that the only person who defines who you are is yourself.
What did you learn on a personal note from this experience?
Well, I learned sign language. That's something, I mean, I've never learned.
Difficult?
Yes, it was very difficult. And I'm not fluent by any means yet, but I know a lot more than when I started. I had no experience with sign language before this show. I could spell my name, and I found out through doing this show I was spelling it wrong. I was doing an R for an S. Yeah. So, like, I've actually never been on a show where I've had the opportunity to learn another language. Oh, I love my coworkers. I love this crew. I love this cast. We have a fabulous network behind us and a fabulous writing and producing team behind us. But it is really nice to show up to work and feel like you are a part of this extended family, so to speak. I adore this cast. And I'm so excited that we actually did get a group of actors who mesh so well together, because I think the audience sees that on screen.
Yeah. What's your character's fashion style?
Oh, well, let's see. Bay is the more difficult, darker of the two switchsters, so to speak, which is kind of similar to myself. I like to wear dark colors. It's because of the dark hair and the translucent skin. So, yeah, she's kind of like our the man who plays John Kenish, my not biological father, but the father who raised me, D.W. Moffat, likes to describe my character as a demented elf. Mostly because I'm short, so he likes to jab at me for that. But she does. She has like this dark sort of like almost ballerina-esque thing to her. Because she does. She dresses very femininely, mm-hmm. is the word that I want to use. But it is. It's very, very edgy. So to speak. Yeah.
Okay. Now, if she had to go shopping, where would she go shopping?
Well, Bay goes to All Saints. Bay goes to Anthropology. Bay has been going to Brandy Melville lately. And Bay, for the summer, has been doing a little bit of Topshop. I can tell you that much.